Retro Nerd.
Hello there. This is James Arnold Taylor, the voice of Obi-Wan Kenobi, and whenever I'm in this part of the galaxy, I listen to Dennis and Jay on podcast Stardust. Makes flying a little more tolerable. Don't tell Anakin.
This is podcast Stardust.
This station is now the ultimate power in the universe.
With Dennis Keithley and Jay Krebs.
Your behavior is continually unexpected.
The galaxy source for Star Wars news, reviews, and discussion.
Now witness the firepower of this fully armed and operational battle station.
Welcome to Podcast Stardust. This is the fully armed and operational podcast dedicated to Star Wars news, reviews, and discussion. I'm Dennis Keithley.
And I'm Jay Krebs.
And it's time for our weekly look at Star Wars news. But first, Jay can remind everybody where they can find us online.
My pleasure as always, Dennis. We are on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Podcast Stardust.
All right. The dish is aligned. The signal is boosted to maximum output. The shield is down. And we're now broadcasting to the galaxy. Here is the week's Star Wars news. And New York Comic Con was last week. And that kind of snuck up on me. I wasn't really paying attention to that. You know, it seems like the big conventions in any given summer or late spring would be Celebration and San Diego Comic-Con and D23. But here was New York Comic-Con, and we ended up getting quite a bit of publishing news for Star Wars out of that, or at least some new looks at things. Had you been following the news when it happened, Jay, or was this all brand new for you?
Not really. I mean, we had covered a lot of the fashion news, you know, and the lifestyle news in World Between Worlds. So that was kind of like my big focus. But then when you had texted me the link and I looked at it, I thought, oh, my gosh, you know, I guess we should have expected that there would be some things coming out of the Comic-Con, but not to this extent. My goodness, there is a ton.
Yeah, I just didn't see or notice. I'm not saying it wasn't out there, but I didn't notice anybody that was attached to Star Wars Publishing or the High Republic, like, you know, saying things like, I'm heading to New York for New York Comic Con or anything like that. It seemed like everybody else in the world was doing that, but they were a little bit more subdued about it. But enough with the build up. Let's dive right on into it. So up first, we had the Star Wars Publishing panel, and it had news about a lot of events, some things that were announced for the High Republic, but then there was also a High Republic panel that had more announcements, but we'll just kind of take these things in the order we have them. Up first, there it was the announcement of a new novel coming from Delilah S. Dawson, who wrote Phasma and Blackspire. But this one is called Inquisitor Rise of the Red Blade, and it tells the story of Iskat, a Jedi survivor of Order 66 that turns to the dark side and joins the Inquisitors with the hope of uncovering the truth about her past. And it'll be arriving in stores sometime in 2023. It looks like the summer of 2023. I knew this one was going to get your attention. What did you think when you saw that, Jay?
Well, I will be honest. When, you know, you sent me that the link originally in our texting, and that was basically the title of the link, I thought, oh my gosh, I hope this is a Fourth Sister tie-in, because, you know, we don't really have anything on her. Mm-hmm. And so, I mean, in a way I was like, aw. But it was great to see the fact that Delilah Dawson is writing this. And she actually also wrote The Perfect Weapon, which is the Bazine Natal tie-in to The Force Awakens. And I absolutely loved that book. So I have to say, you know, to choose Delilah S. Dawson to write this book, I think is a perfect, perfect choice. Mm-hmm. And I think that she will definitely give a great voice to Iskat, and I'm really excited to meet her. So I see that this looks this isn't Deveronian, is this? It's a red-skinned humanoid, and I can't decide what species this
see,
is.
See, it's
the
a
cover.
Little hard to tell what they're doing there, because yeah. I was wondering the same thing. Did they intend to make this look like a Deveronian, or is it just that they made the skin red to match the lightsaber? Mm-hmm. You know, because otherwise the cover that they've teased us with is in black and white.
Right.
So, you know, it's a, yeah, it's a little hard to tell at the moment, but yeah, I can't wait to find out more about this book. I really, really, really enjoyed Phasma. I thought it was a great novel. It was a really cool setup to The Force Awakens. Of course, it came out after The Force Awakens, but still, nice tie into that book. I liked Black Spire, and as much as I love Galaxy's Edge, my one complaint about Black Spire, it was just like a little bit too much giving us a tour of Black Spire Outpost before you go to Disneyland or Disney Hollywood Studios to go to Galaxy's Edge and stuff like that. You know, they made sure that you got a peek inside Oz Cantina and the Resistance area and, you know, Docking Bay 97 and all these other areas that show up in Galaxy's Edge. They're, you know, they had to be included in that book. And so it was good. It was a good story. I liked it. But for me, what really shined was the Phasma novel between the two. So again, I'm excited for this one as well. I like Delilah's style of writing, and I cannot wait to see what she does with this character. Mm-hmm. So we also got the announcement at that Star Wars publishing panel of the High Republic Chronicles of the Jedi, which is described as an in-universe guide to the High Republic, which is being written by Cole Horton, and they shared some pages there that covered the Republic Fair, the High Council, and some that had some general character studies as well. So it's not quite like the art of book that you and I have been like desperately pleading for, but I do like that we seem to be getting this illustrated guide that is going to, I think, kind of fill out the, you know, what we've been looking for in that respect.
Mm-hmm. No, I would agree. And I mean, the artwork that's here is really, really spectacular. And like you said, I mean, it's not exactly what we were hoping for, but it's definitely a great supplement to the things that we've seen so far, and also kind of introduces us to some new fun things as well.
Yeah. And they're billing it as, you know, a great supplement, you know, the word you're just using, to the novels, the comics, and the other stories that have been coming out, or as a jumping on point. So if you haven't been keeping up with everything, you could dive into this and get up to speed on what's going on in the High Republic. I'm really curious that, you know, they're describing this as an in-universe guide. Well, from whose perspective, I suppose?
Mm.
And when is this set exactly? Because, you know, we've seen a lot happen in phase one, and phase two is 150 years in the past. So is it being given us as kind of like a guide and history book? Or is this, you know, they've done a number of things that are told from some character's perspective as like in a journal or, you know, or something like that. So I'm really eager to see how that turns out.
Yeah, me too, for sure. And when you click on it in the Star Wars website, it takes you to another external site that just talks about some of the characters that we definitely are very familiar with. So it talks about Avar Chris, Bell Zedifar, Selen Geos, Keeve Trennis, Briaga, Yoda, and more, as they say. So yeah, but I think my the most exciting thing for me anyway is the fact that we're getting the art by Ario Anandito, who I absolutely love as an artist. So that for me is a win.
Yeah, his work on the comic has been fantastic.
Oh yeah, for sure.
So, all right, well, we also are getting the High Republic, the Lightsaber Collection, which will be coming in April 2023. And this is a follow-up to the 2020s book, the Lightsaber Collection. Did you ever spend much time with the 2020s Lightsaber Collection book?
I didn't, and I would love to, honestly, because these lightsabers, of course, just being the High Republic and this Knights of the Round Table feel, the hilts and everything just enamor me so much. But I know we got some of that on the High Republic show that Kristen Baber and Christina Ariel had hosted. So, I mean, that in and of itself was awesome because I did a lot of pausing and things like that, but I didn't get a chance to spend any time really with the book. But did you?
Yeah, I have a copy of it here.
Nice.
And I have not actually read it cover to cover yet. I picked it up and flipped through it a few times, and then I put it on a place where my shelf where it was kind of out of sight. So I need to get it out and dive into it more. But it is a cool book. And so I am excited to see that they're making a follow-up that is going to give us some of these hilts that were being used by the Jedi in the High Republic time period. Because like you're just saying that, you know, some of them are just so ornate. And it's so different than what we're used to with all the cross guards and everything else that they put into that. And it's just a different style that they had, you know, because so many of the lightsabers from the original trilogy, sequel trilogy, and prequel trilogy, you know, they're just all much more cylindrical.
Right.
That's a tough word to say. But frequently more industrial looking. And, whereas the Jedi of the High Republic, you know, they almost look like magic weapons. So, kind of cool.
Makes you wonder, where did that transition start to take place, you know?
Yeah, good question.
Food for thought.
So then also from the Star Wars publishing panel, we got a sneak peek at Star Wars Timelines, which is the full story of the Star Wars saga in chronological order. And it'll be covering everything from the movies, the various television series, the comics, the books, and more. And it is arriving on February 7th, 2023. I knew this was an ambitious project, but just these blurbs that I've been seeing about this project from New York Comic Con and some of the pages they shared, I think they did some like on Poe Dameron.
Mm-hmm.
It really looks like it is more ambitious than I thought and more in depth than I thought it was going to be. They really seem to be pouring a lot of detail into that.
Oh, yeah. And these are, of course, just taking the place of everything that has come before it, obviously, because it's the most up-to-date chronological compilation of everything and anything. And I remember when I was first getting back into Star Wars again, I had a student at school who had all of these different visual dictionaries, and they were very similar to this in the way that they were set up, but they were much more segregated in the way that they basically address specific eras of the timeline. Whereas, you know, it looks like this one is going to be really intertwined with everything that was going on at the time, because those particular books were, I feel like, a lot more streamlined, I guess you could say. Whereas this one, you know, as you pointed out, it's got so many things going on at once, and just learning about what the ABY and BBY means. I had actually to teach Craig that, my husband, when we were watching Andor. But yeah, I mean, just seeing some of these panels from even the comic books that we've read as part of the artwork that is going into this, I think is really cool.
Yeah. I'm just excited that they're putting all that in there. And
oh, yeah.
Because, you know, there's video games, there are web series, there's, you know, there's just all kinds of different things that they could draw from. And to see them, you know, put it all in one place is just, like I said, it's ambitious.
Yeah,
so
sure.
I'm looking forward to getting my hands on that one and spending some time with it. And, you know, you read these things, and we all know Star Wars so well. But then you come across something that you just forgot about, or maybe there's a detail you missed along the way, and it gives you a chance to go back and read a book or a comic or revisit a movie or one of the live action series or the animated series again, to just go back and see that thing that you didn't notice the first time. It gives you a new way of looking at the stuff. So I'm looking forward to seeing where that takes us.
Yeah.
Well, there were some other announcements from the Star Wars publishing panel. We're going to get into some of the comic stuff in just a bit. But then, you know, they teased a few other things that we've kind of already, or didn't know so much tease. They revisited a number of things that we've already discussed about quite a bit in our news. So I'm not going to go over those again, but let's shift over to the High Republic panel. And up first, we got the cover reveal for Lydia King's novel, which is coming in April 2023, which is Cataclysm. And on the cover is featured Axel Greylart, who is carrying a blaster and a purple lightsaber.
Mm-hmm.
Now, this is the son of one of the chancellors. So I'm curious to see what this is all about, because, I know, as far as I know, he wasn't a Jedi. But so whose lightsaber is he carrying?
Yeah, and a purple one to boot. Mm-hmm. So, yeah, for sure. I know I was a little confused by this cover when I first saw it. And so I know you had sent this to me as well. And so I had to look at it and look at it again and then realize who I was looking at. And yeah, that's going to be a very interesting reveal. And I love his look. I love his robes and his little ornaments and things that he's got going on in there.
Right. And we're going to meet him in Convergence, which comes out next month.
Mm-hmm.
I'm also wondering about what looks like these orb looking ships in the background that are flying over the horizon. They kind of look like the Trade Federation's core of their ships. And, you know, we got teased that with these Trade Federation ships in one of the video games that's in development right now. I can't remember which one it was, but is this related to that or what's going on?
Interesting. Yes, seems that the plot is thickening once again.
Mm-hmm. So, yeah, well, we've got plenty of time and a lot more material in the High Republic that's coming before that, before we get our reveal. And then we also got a look at the cover for Quest for Planet X, which is a book being written by Tessa Gratton, and it is arriving in April of 2023. It is features a number of characters, including a Jedi, and they're going to Batuu.
Woo.
So, yeah, I thought that was cool that they're tying now the High Republic into Batuu and Galaxy's Edge. What would you think?
Oh, yeah. It's always great to see those tie-ins. And is this one more of a middle-grade novel then? Because just from the illustration on the front, it just kind of gives me that feeling.
Yeah, it's in the style that they've been doing the middle-grade novels. And, you know, they have a notation that this cover is not final. But, mm-hmm. you know, Tessa just co-wrote The Path of Deceit with Justina mm-hmm. Ireland, which is the young adult novel. I don't think she's getting her own adult novel in this phase of the High Republic, so it would make sense that maybe she's writing the middle grade one. But hey, you and I had such a great time when we were at Galaxy's Edge with our families, and I'm always up for seeing more stories set there or touching upon events that go on there. But what makes this unique is that it's 450 years prior to anything that we know mm-hmm. about Batuu and Galaxy's Edge or Black Spire Outpost, whatever you want to call it.
Yes, indeed. And one thing that stands out to me about this cover is I know it says cover not final, but the lightsaber that the young Jedi is holding is that white? It's a white lightsaber.
Well, it looks like it's got a blue cast to it, though. Mm-hmm. Not sure. And but, you know, it looks like they're standing right in front of the area where you usually see the Millennium Falcon. So,
it does indeed.
I'm really curious to see that. And, you know, we've seen white lightsabers in the High Republic. Orla Jireni had a double-bladed white lightsaber. And mm-hmm. I'm still hoping we get that story someday. How she got the white kyber crystals. Because as far as we know, you have to heal kyber crystals that have been bled.
Right.
In order to do that. So.
Right.
Yeah. Okay. And then we have a cover for Path of Vengeance, which is being written by Kevin Scott and arriving in May of 2023. On the cover, they've teased us that we have Marta Rowe wandering into a cavern. She's flanked by two Jedi, and they say, is that the Nameless that are inside the cavern here? So, I have thoughts on this that I am going to squelch until you had an opportunity to read Path of Deceit. I don't want to give anything away. I'm super excited to see what Kevin Scott does with this material, given how great a job he did with the High Republic comics, and he did with The Rising Storm and everything else he touched in the High Republic, you know, Tempest Runner and the like. I'm really eager to see the story he crafts around these characters.
Oh, yeah. Well, I'm assuming this has to do with the Path of the Open Hand and with Marta being on the cover of this. It's very mystic looking, and as you said, that does it's looking like the Nameless there, mm-hmm. and you know, very astral in its look, but great cover.
Yeah, I'm really looking forward to reading this book, Jay, because I can't wait to discuss it with you. But hey,
I'm on chapter 3.
Okay, all right,
I'll get there.
Yeah, I know you will. I know you will. So we also had a some art that was teased by Ario Anandito, featuring Kraydon and the Twinkle Sisters, and they will apparently be showing up in the Marvel flagship title for the High Republic. I've read the first issue. These characters are not in it, so I don't know exactly when we're getting them, but they look imposing. I'm not sure how these two got the name of Twinkle Sisters, because they look like two giant ogres there. They're not pretty at all. They're very, very, very tough looking, but that seems like such a Kevin Scott thing to do.
Oh my goodness, I know. Kevin Scott, or you know, even Daniel Jose Older, because he's always joking about things, but maybe it just means that they will kill you in the twinkle of an eye.
Oh, I see what you did there. Okay. Very good. Yeah, I don't even know who Creighton is either, but another intriguing character. So, So we're all wondering about Buriaga because he was missing in action after The Fallen Star, which is the last adult novel in phase one. Well, we're going to get a story with him. It's being written by Charles Soule and his daughter, Rosemary, arriving in October 23. It is a children's book. The cover features Buriaga and Yoda. They're being very coy about when this book is set. So we have no idea if this is before The Fallen Star or after the events of The Fallen Star, what exactly is happening. So you can't accept this yet that Buriaga has survived. Right. I'm hoping so, but it's a cute looking cover. Well, what do you think?
Oh, it is indeed. It's very heartwarming. And, you know, Buri has definitely become one of our favorites for sure. And to see Buri and Yoda together on the front of a children's book cover brings warm feelings to my heart, as Yoda would say.
Right. Yeah, I'm glad to see Charles Soule's putting out more work. I mean, this is not aimed at us. I know he's just finished up his fourth novel, which is not a Star Wars book. So I suspect that's one of the reasons why we haven't seen more from him in the novel sphere, the book sphere for the High Republic. And it's been, you know, after The Light of the Jedi, he was, you know, he did the two-parter on Martian Row and other bits and pieces here and there, but he hasn't contributed as many bigger works as Justine Ireland, Daniel Jose Older, Kevin Scott, and Claudia Gray. So, yeah, I'm hoping this is going to kind of open the floodgates and we get more from him, especially in phase three.
Yes. And I didn't realize that Kevin Scott's daughter, Rosemary, was a writer as well. Or not Kevin Scott, Charles Soule's daughter, yeah. Rosemary, was a writer. How old is she?
I have no idea. So, you know, I'm with you. I didn't take Charles Soule's to be someone who would have necessarily an adult daughter. But I don't really know how old he is either, for that matter. So maybe it's just something that he got input from, you know, his children when he was working on. And that's distinctly possible. So we got a little bit more information on Quest of the Jedi, which is being written by Claudia Gray. It's a 30-page one-shot comic arriving in February 2023. The cover features Vildar Mak and a Twi'lek. The Twi'lek appears to have blue skin. I'm wondering if that is just a trick of the lightsaber light, because we know he meets Padawan Mathia Cathley in the first issue of Volume 2 of The High Republic, but she's got that like magenta, purple, maroon skin, or whatever the color is, and it's not blue, so I'm not sure who that's supposed to be.
Well, just perhaps another new character. Hard to say.
Yeah, it seems like from all of the cover reveals for the main title that Vildar is kind of always teamed up with her. So I guess I was just expecting that team up to continue over to other stories. So it just kind of threw me for a loop.
Mm-hmm. And maybe it's just the, you know, colorization in the draft is a little different. Who knows?
Yeah, you're right. Shouldn't necessarily look too much into it, because that cover could change between now and then too. And they could also color correct, so who knows. But we are not done with the manga coming out for the High Republic. They made the announcement of The Edge of Balance Phase 2. The first book is being written by Daniel Jose Older and Tomio Ogata, and the title is The Edge of Balance Precedent, which will be arriving in May of 2023. Which is interesting timing, because that seems like that's right as phase two is kind of ending. So I guess it's going to be more of an epilogue type of a story, or some sort of transitional story between the events of phase two and phase one. So I don't know. I know we enjoyed those first two books that they had for The Edge of Balance, but I'm curious to see what they do with this one.
Right. Yeah. Well, the first Edge of Balance that we got was kind of smack dab in the middle of the first phase. And then the second one was actually kind of towards the end. So maybe, you know, perhaps this is sort of following suit with that kind of thing. But if it's just a one-off kind of manga, then yeah, it is an interesting placement.
Right. And the thing about it is that the second Edge Balance, you know, it had that almost cliffhanger ending you know, what was going to happen to those characters between phase one and now what's going to happen in phase three. Whereas, unless they're going to go back and like give us a phase four, which picks up between phase two and phase one, that's confusing. Yes. You know, I don't know that they can do that or exactly what they're going to do. So, you know, it may be just its own contained story. It'll be interesting to see. So,
Yep.
And then the last bit of High Republic news that we got was the announcement of a young adult anthology, which is going to have contributions from all the authors of the High Republic. So Zoraida Cordova, Tessa Grattan, Claudia Gray, Justina Ireland, Lydia King, George Mann, Daniel Jose Older, Kevin Scott, and Charles Soule. And that will be arriving in July of 2023, and it will touch on all phases of the High Republic, including phase three. This is really cool because we can get more adventures from all the characters we like, which potentially, you know, they haven't said who they're writing about and stuff like that, but then it'll be giving us some teases of events of that are going on during phase three. So I might be the most excited for that out of all the stuff they announced at the High Republic panel or for the publishing panel for that matter.
I have to say I'm with you. I mean, this is outstanding because as you said, it really does tie everything together. I mean, it's got, you know, the original characters and then the ones we're getting now and then tying into some new things. And then that's definitely an all-star list of authors that are participating. And I have to say, you know, the whole High Republic initiative has just been so impressive in the way that they have drilled these things out. And, you know, as much as sometimes we're like, oh, not sure we're going to like it this way, I mean, they've really done a great job of planning and implementing all of these different phases and just the different types of media between the comics and the books and the manga and everything. And it's just, yeah, it's just so great. So hats off.
Yeah, very well said. The publishing initiative that is the High Republic, you know, when it was first coming out, we knew there was going to be comics, we knew there was going to be some books, but yeah, we certainly didn't know the volume of stuff that they were going to be doing here and how many different types of media it was going to be. And I'm eager to see how Acolyte ties into all of this. You know, our live action show coming on Disney Plus that's set towards the end of the High Republic, and we got video games coming out. They really are hitting as many different forms of media as they can with this era, which is really encouraging because it's so hard for them to put new stories in the original trilogy era, the prequel trilogy, because again, you know, there's already been so much there and you have to be very careful about doing anything with those characters because, you know, that's what appeals to the mass audience. And you don't want to confine someone who wants to make a movie about one of these characters necessarily by something that happens in a comic book. And, you know, there's always that balancing act they're trying to do there. But, you know, they don't have those constraints with the High Republic. The source material will be the books and the comics. And then, you know, whatever stories they want to tell in a movie, should they ever want to do that, would have to conform to those things, which is a very opposite way of doing it.
And we still have our hopes up that we'll still get something on television, either live action or animated or something.
I'll sign up for all.
Yes, for sure.
All right. Okay, so we just got a little bit of comic news to finish this all up. They did announce at New York Comic Con that Sana Staros is getting her own miniseries from Marvel. It's being written by Justina Ireland, so I guess she's stepping away a little bit from the High Republic to do this.
Yeah.
That will be arriving in February 2023. Very cool. I think Sana's been a cool character. I mean, you know, she's been a companion to Dr. Aphra for a while, so I'm eager to read more of her adventures. But what do you think?
Oh, yeah, this is super cool. And just a quick aside, I was actually at my local comic book store, and they have these comic book display action figures, and Sana Staros was one of them. And I thought, oh my gosh, this is amazing. And I've never seen them packaged this way before. And there was a collection of different comic book, like, cover type things. And so it's like, oh my gosh, this is incredible to see something like this just even being released.
Are you talking about the variant covers that look like a Kenner action figure?
Yes.
Or are you talking?
Yes. No. They're actually, the inner action figures themselves are, they're not the 3 3/4 inch. They're the little bigger ones. But it opens up. Yeah. It opens up like a comic book.
Oh, which very is really cool.
Yeah.
Okay. I was just at a comic store last week and I didn't see those. That's interesting. I'll have to check that out.
It's brand new. Yeah.
Yeah, and then just the last bit is that this week we had the debut issue of Volume 2 of The High Republic from Marvel. I got a chance to read it. I really enjoyed it. It ties into the events of Path of Deceit very clearly, or at least you can see the relationship between those things. And again, I'm not going to say too much more because that would be spoiler territory. But the one thing I will mention is that we speculated when we talked about the excerpt from issue one that Vildar Mack was a Kiffar. Yeah, he's definitely a Kiffar. And okay, if we just paid more attention to the Kiffex notation on the first page of that excerpt, we probably could have put two and two together a lot more smoothly than we did. But yeah, so that's cool. And he seems to be a fun character that'll be fun to follow over the course of this comic.
Awesome. Looking forward to it.
Yeah. All right. Well, there you go. It's been a very publishing heavy edition of Star Wars news, but hey, that's what we got from New York Comic Con. It was a lot of fun to discuss. We hoped you enjoyed listening to us discuss it. And so that will do it for this episode of Podcast Stardust. And if you enjoyed the episode, we'd hope you'd consider subscribing to Podcast Stardust on your podcatcher of choice if you haven't already done so. We'd like to remind you can find all episodes of the podcast over on RetroZap.com, which is also home to several other great podcasts covering everything in pop culture from the MCU, DC, Dune, and other fan favorite shows. And as always, we greatly appreciate your 5-star ratings and reviews on whatever podcatcher it is that you use, especially Apple Podcasts. And also, if you're being kind, don't forget to share the show and your favorite episodes on social media with your friends. Speaking of which, Jay, what are our online contacts one last time?
All right. So we can easily be found on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram at Podcast Stardust. And if you are into Pinterest, we do have some Pinterest boards and a YouTube channel, which has all of our past episodes, as well as our unboxing videos of some really great products. So head over there, like, and subscribe. And we do have a Discord room on the RetroZap Discord server. We are one of many rooms. All the RetroZap shows have their own rooms over there. And there's also some other dedicated rooms to some fun things. So just go to our show page, click on the community tab, and you are there. And if you are in need of some new home goods, some new apparel, coffee mugs, magnets for your fridge, we do have a TeePublic store. So we are teepublic.com/user/podcaststardust. And we do have 7 different show logo designs available. And every once in a while, they're having some really good sales. So if you catch it just right, you can get 30, 35% off or even some free shipping. So again, that's teepublic.com/user/podcaststardust.
All right, Jay, before we go, do you have anything about cosplay you want to share with everyone?
Oh, yes. So this coming weekend, actually, I will be making 2 appearances. So I will be at Operation Fandom in Medina, Ohio for their grand opening from 2 to 6 p.m. as Ahsoka. And then on Sunday, I will be appearing in New Philadelphia, Ohio as part of the Art on the Alley extravaganza, where there will be a photo booth set up, and I will be the 4th sister helping to raise money for the Tuscarora Sports Arts Partnership. So if you get a chance on either of those days and you're in the area, come down and say hi, and you can always follow me on j.snipscosplay on Instagram.
All right. Well, that'll do it for episode 478 of Podcast Stardust. Thanks for listening, everyone. And until next time, may the Force be with you.